A 10-meter ladder is leaning against a building. I have included a picture so we can get a better visual representation of what this question is stating. We have a 10-meter long ladder that is leaning against a building. The base of the ladder is 5 meters from the base of the building. How high up the wall of the building is the ladder leaning? We're trying to calculate the height where the ladder is leaning against the building. Because this is a right triangle, we can use what is called the Pythagorean theorem, which states there's a relationship between the sides of the triangle such that a squared plus b squared equals c squared. The a and the b are the two, what we call the two legs. These two are the legs because they make up the right angle. The side that is opposite the right angle is known as the hypotenuse. It is always used to be side C. So sides A and B can be interchangeable. It does not matter which of these two lengths are the sides because they're both squared and then they're both added together. So we can let the leg here be our side A. So we would have 5 squared. Side B is actually H, our variable, squared. And side C, of course, is the hypotenuse, which is 10 squared. 5 squared is 25. The height squared stays h squared, and 10 squared is 100. To calculate for the height, we would first need to subtract our 25 from both sides. The height squared would equal 75. This, remember, is the height squared, so the square of our height is 75. We want to know what a single height would be. In order for the square to be canceled out, we would need to take the square root on both sides. So we take the square root of the 75. That gives us our answer for part A. Notice that it does say do not simplify, so we can leave it as the square root of 75. The part B asks us to approximate the answer to 3 decimal spaces. Now, I can't just simply stop at 3 decimal spaces. I would need to know what at least the 4th space is. There are even more decimal spaces than this, but they're really irrelevant. If I'm asked to round to 3, I only need to know what the 4th one is so that I can then round it back. Because that 4th number is less than 5, anything less than 5 makes you round down, which means that I take and drop that number back to a 0. So to 3 decimal spaces, it would be 8.660. But even because that number is a 0 as well, I could even round that further back and just write it as 8 and 66 hundredths.